don't know who I am, let me educate you real quickly. I am the third longest reigning champion in NGWF history. I am a four-time West Coast champion, tag team champion, and rage champion. I have beaten and fought the best. There is nobody better than me. I came back to the NGWF for one reason only, and that is to become champion again, and I will do so no matter the cost. I have with me two wrestlers. No, two unstoppable forces of nature. Dokes and Mercedes. They were smart enough to join me. And I will help them achieve superstardom. You wanna know why? Because Mercedes and Dokes have potential. And if there's one thing that I appreciate, it's potential. Thus, we created the Wolfpack Legion, and we will take over. Dawn of Destruction, the reason why Dokes and Mercedes attacked you is because they want to become tag team champions. There is nobody in the NGWF who deserves to become tag team champions more than these two. You will put your tag team titles on the line at Apocamania. And if you don't, we will terrorize every single human being in the NGWF until you finally give in to our demands. For Iroquois, you have never faced anyone like me. The only reason why you are king of NGWF, because you have not faced me. At Apocamania, I will end your streak. You are too prideful to ignore me. You cannot and will not ignore me. You will face me, Apocamania, and you will put your streak on the line. I will end it, and I'll submit my legacy as the greatest NGWF wrestler of all time. We are the Legion, and you cannot stop us. Our way true to the Legion.
Episode of Monday Night Drop Zone. I am your host and co-owner, because apparently I've been demoted thanks to Achilles' heel, of NGWF. I'm sorry, I'm just really frustrated with Achilles' heel and how they're trying to slow us down, how they're trying to sabotage our show going into Pocamania. They just don't like the fact that NGWF is going to become its own separate brand, and I'm just frustrated with them. Anyway, we have a matchup right here, and it's going to be a women's tag team matchup, a first here in the NGWF. The women's champion, Miss Jessie, will be teaming up with the 7-foot-tall cowgirl, Gianna Lord. The number one contender for the women's title, Sun Lee, and Miss Gwynn, who is a member of a very odd group known as the Family. As Jesse holding that title high, who knows how much longer she's going to hold that title. But she's going to face Sun Lee in quite possibly the biggest event in NJWF's history. It's absolutely going to be groundbreaking, ladies and gentlemen. We're only one episode away from Apocamania. So, after this episode, only one more episode to remain, and then we will have, quite possibly, the most hardcore, the most in-your-face, the most intense event of the year. And I'm just not tooting my own horn on that. I guarantee you it's going to be one of the most... It's going to be one of the most action-packed events you will ever see. And there's Miss Gwen, the seductive succubus. It's kind of redundant considering what a succubus actually really is. Maybe Miss Gwen doesn't know that. Don't tell her. Anyway, here comes out the number one contender for the women's title, the Red Warrior, Sun Lee. Now, Sun Lee is just a beast. She has yet to be stopped ever since, adopting this new attitude, ever since becoming a client of Jesse Odul. No one's been able to stop her. Right now, she's undefeated in singles competition. So we're going to have to see what happens in Apocamania when this woman goes up against the women's champion. I mean, honestly, I see Miss Jessie losing to Sun Lee. Sun Lee has been nothing short of dominant as of late. And Miss Jessie, say what you want about the sexy saint, she is extremely talented in more ways than one. But I don't know. I really think Sun Lee may have a number. Oh, dropkick from Miss Gwen, who went to the Heart Dungeon to train to become a professional wrestler. And John Anord, oh my god! Springboard clothesline! I just can't get over the fact of how athletic John Anord is for a 7-foot-tall woman. Oh, damn! And Miss Gwen, who is not very tall, she's only like 4'11". Oh, here we go. Bounces off the ropes. Drop toe hold. Oh, elbow drop right to the back. And what is Miss Jessie going to do here? And she... And... Oh! Toe hold backbreaker. Of course, Miss Jessie... Well, she did not go to a prestigious school. Oh. She was trained by her husband, the player Will Jones, on how to fight. Player Will Jones, of course, is one half of America's Most Hated. Wait a minute. What is Miss Jessie going to do here? Those in the corner. Miss Jessie now tags in John Anord. Pretty good teamwork from these two. John Anord's going up. Oh, double axe handle right to the arm. Miss Gwen! Oh, she really had to get leverage on that neck breaker in order to bring this giant woman to the ground. Wait a minute. Here we go. Miss Gwen's helping Sun Lee. It's... Oh! Cross body. DDT from Sun Lee. Right now, she's absolutely dominating. Oh, John Anord. Boots right to the back. Ouch. Oh! What's Sun Lee gonna do here? Puts on the top. Oh, no. Oh, no. No! No way! Oh! Wow! Fallaway slam from the top rope. Wow! That is impressive. Considering the fact John Anord weighs a hell of a lot more than Sun Lee does, but this through all that training that Sun Li had in Japan. And Sun Li throws Miss Jessie, into the turnbuckle. And DDT on John Annoyed. Right now she is fighting both. Oh, wait a minute. Miss Jessie gets in a cheap shot. Sun Li tags in Miss Gwynn. Miss Gwynn goes for a dropkick. John Annoyed wisely gets out of the way. Oh, but Miss Gwynn gets that one. Wait a minute. What is Miss Gwynn going to do? John Annoyed's got her. Miss Gwynn reverses. Back body slam. Miss Gwynn is just taking the right to her. What's going to happen here? Oh, dropkick right to the head. Now, since Miss Gwynn is indeed part of the family, I guess I could talk about him just for a short period of time. Wait a minute. Oh, never mind. Pile driver. Well, I was going to talk about them. I guess I could do it real quick. Okay, after the double drop. Wait a minute. Miss Gwynn now is just circling John Annoyed. John Annoyed needs to get in the tag. Now, the family has been having a rivalry as of late with America's Most Hated. It all started back at, the pre-show of Independence Brawl, where the family just outright destroyed America's Most Hated. And ever since America's Most Hated, they've changed their tactics. Rather than trying to be your, total backbreaker, while trying to be your typical standard tag team, America's Most Hated, they have become more like street fighters in a way. They just want good old-fashioned brutality, you know. Every match they've been in ever since having this new attitude, they have make the opponents bleed. They bleed hardcore matches to the extreme. Oh, wow. Miss Gwynn is now, and Sun Li are both in control. Oh, man. Of course, Miss Gwynn came here from SCWF. Wait a minute. Here we go. Another pile driver. See, here in the NGWF, we like to give equal opportunity to everyone. That includes the women. Oh, wait a minute. What is this? And Sunplex! John Annoyed wisely gets out of the way. Oh, Sun Li manages to hurt herself along with hurting John Annoyed. Miss Jessie is just, she's wisely staying out of the way. Wait a minute, she's coming after Miss Gwynn. Oh. And once again, another Sunplex. Now she goes for the pin. One, two, three. And Sun Li and Miss Gwynn win the first ever women's tag team match here on Drop Zone. Let's look at the highlights of this very interesting women's tag team matchup. You know, for a first-time match, this actually was, rather entertaining. I do have to say, these women put on one hell of a show, if you ask me. Though in the end, Sun Li once again proved her dominance. Once again, has only concreted my belief that Miss Jessie's time as women's champion is up at Apocamania. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our second match here at NGWF Monday Night Drop Zone. Coming down to the ring is the number one contender for the lightweight championship. We've won that ability, that honor, becoming a number one contender. It's for the lightweight title. He's going to be facing against Vindictator at Apocamania this match. He will be facing Vindictator one-on-one, and we're going to see who's going to have some momentum going into Apocamania. Of course, these two will meet again on the next episode, the last episode leading up to Apocamania. So be sure to check that out. He looks like he is all ready. He is ready for this match. He is ready to prove that he belongs here in the NGWF. And, well, we'd also... Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, the lightweight champion, Vin Dictator. This is Vin Dictator's second time winning the lightweight championship. He won that title, I think, like maybe 2 or 3 months ago. I have to go back and look. But definitely, he's held it long enough. Let's just say that. As much as I'm a fan of Vin Dictator, he's kind of an arrogant, pompous ass. You know, he's not exactly someone who... Whoa! He's not exactly someone who you can have a conversation with. And if you can have a conversation with him, he always talks about himself, you know? Very... Very self-centered is Vin Dictator. Of course, when you have the name Dictator in your name, I guess it kind of comes with the territory. Yeah. But not to say that Vin Dictator is not a talented wrestler. He's extremely talented. But maybe Weed is a little bit more talented. Oh, with a super hurricanrana. That is just a thing of absolute beauty. 10 out of 10. Wait a minute. Dictator, wait a minute, what is he gonna do? Picks him up, oh, drops him down with that beautiful suplex. Oh, brings him down with a sleeper hold slam. These two love to get on the ropes. These two love to do high-flying, high-risk maneuvers. And, yes, I did say Reed likes to do a little bit of high-flying. Both in and out of the ring, if you catch my drift. Oh! I haven't seen that before. Wait a minute, here we go! Oh! We managed to get out of the way of Vindictator's springboard maneuver. Dropkick from the Vindictator. Wait a minute. Oh! Man! Vindictator right now. What's he gonna do? Once again, gotta go for a suplex, and he's gonna try to end this early. One, only a one count. Oh, look at those furious kicks and a clothesline from Weed. What are we gonna do now? Brings him in, got him in a headlock. Oh, jawbreaker. It was a vicious one at that. Oh, Weed is definitely being in the fight to Vin Dictator, that's for sure, but Vin Dictator with a hurricanrana. Oh my god, what a hurricanrana. And now, right after his arm. Now, taking the boots right to him. Try going for a dropkick, weaves out of the way, but he can't evade that hurricanrana. Oh, now Weed is back in control. Well, he was. Oh, another hurricanrana from Vin Dictator. Looks like Vin Dictator's got Weed's number right now. And wait a minute. Oh! Ow! That foot DDT is just being so much pain. Oh, an agony to your leg. But not as much pain and agony as a flapjack. Where's Weed going? I have no idea. He's just running around. And, oh, another flapjack. Man. Oh, here we go. It's only a matter of time before Vin Dictator grabs a chair or some sort of weapon. Wait a minute! Oh! Suicide dive outside! My god! Oh! Slams his face right down to the mat! Right on the concrete! Wait a minute. What is Vin Dictator gonna do here? Uh-oh. Oh, no. No! Oh! Dictator. Just. Oh, man. This has got to be the beginning of. Oh, now he's taking that ring bell. Just smashing him. across his back. Oh, now in the back of the head. Oh! The Dictator is a... He is in complete control of this matchup right now. I mean, Weed is... Oh! I believe Weed is done for. I mean... Getting speared through the guardrails like that. Now, with the ring bell, and now with this chair. Oh! The Dictator is trying to do everything he can, I believe, to injure Weed. Oh! So when they actually face an Apocamania, Weed cannot defeat this man. Wait a minute! Neckbreaker! Oh, knee right to the face. Weed, he's fighting back! He is coming back! What's he gonna do? Throws him! But the Dictator comes back! Oh, neckbreaker! Man, what is the Dictator gonna do here? There's a... on the top! Wow! Not entirely sure what that was, but wow! The Dictator, oh, pushes down Weed, and now, oh, he's been working on the legs of Weed, also his arms and also his torso, everywhere and anywhere. Oh, here we go! Hail the Dictator! His finishing maneuver, this could be it. One, two, three, it's done. The Dictator, the lightweight champion, just, man, Weed started off good. He seemed to have somewhat of an edge, but as soon as the Dictator speared him through the guardrail and then started to just bash him repeatedly with a time belt, then with a chair. There's not a whole lot we can do. Well, maybe we'll see this at Apocamania. Maybe not. But tonight, the Dictator walks away with a victory. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our third match. It is between number one contender, Komodo Dragon, versus the Rage Champion. Comes out OJ, a name that everyone all over the globe can say with absolute certainty. Oh, hey, OJ is definitely a multi-time champion here at NGWF. His loyalty is with NGWF. He spent a very brief time at SCWF and just said it was just garbage. Here he says, This is home, being in front of these hundreds and hundreds of NGWF fans from all over the globe. He says this is where he loves to fight. This is his style. This, to him, is his stage. Look at those fans. Listen to those fans. Those fans just love OJ. Because OJ was a third-grade champion, a one-time lightweight champion, a two-time West Coast champion, oh, and a three-time core champion. It's not a whole hell of a lot for OJ to accomplish. Oh! OJ even claims one of these days he will try to capture the NGWF World Championship. He does want to try to headline, oh, a major event here in the NGWF, but I don't know, OJ. If you can beat Komodo Dragon both here tonight and in Apocamania, I think you're definitely set. Oh, man. Now, OJ, oh, try taking a fight with Komodo Dragon, but Komodo Dragon is too strong. Oh. Komodo Dragon looking to become a three-time Rage champion at Apocamania. And honestly, as much passion and as much heart as OJ has, Komodo Dragon is just tougher. He's stronger. He's endured a hell of a lot more than OJ, let me tell you. Ninja Komodo Dragon, he's beaten many big names here in the NGWF. Big names such as K-9, Mad Dog, The Wolf, The Bum, Strife, Z-Man, and he even has beaten the likes of K-9, Big Chalupa, and, oh wait a minute, oh, here we go, and he's also beaten Chaos. All of these guys, with the exception of Chaos, were former NGWF World Champions. So that right there should tell you something about Komodo Dragon. Right now, OJ looks like he's at the mercy of Komodo Dragon, who is just uncharacteristically, I believe I said, oh, wow! I do believe I have said that word correctly, but it doesn't really matter. I think you understand what I'm saying. He's using submission maneuvers, which is completely unlike Komodo Dragon. Komodo Dragon just likes to get in there and just destroy his opponents. I don't know, maybe he's trying to change his style. Oh, ever since he adopted this new look of his, I mean, he's definitely been trying new things, and his finishing maneuvers are unlike anything I've ever seen before. I mean, a powerbomb off the top rope, and he also does his own little variation of a frog splash. So he's definitely changing his look, he's changing his moves. Oh, but OJ. OJ's a quick learner, so we're going to have to see. Oh, of course, 2 weeks ago, OJ had an incredible street fight with the NGWF world champion, The Rapture. And while OJ did not win that matchup, he definitely proved that he can hang with the world champion. And of course, Rapture and OJ definitely have a... Oh, wow, that unorthodox offense of OJ. Sorry, but OJ and the Rapture definitely have a bit of a history. Of course, that was before the Rapture became what he is today. In fact, the Rapture wasn't always known as, well, Rapture. He was known as the Bum. And then, of course, the Bum became the Rapture. Wait a minute. Another Dragon. What's he going to do? Picks him up. Oh, backbreaker. He almost made OJ submit in that submission maneuver. I'm seeing him blabbering. Oh! Knee to the face, and now OJ's been busted wide open. It was the second episode now that OJ's been busted wide open by someone who is much stronger than he is, a lot more vicious. But OJ's a fighter, man. He is also a survivor. Wait a minute. He picked up OJ. Oh! Wow! Look at the strength of Komodo Dragon. Oh, face. That him around and then drops Lana on his back. Two. No. OJ's still in this thing. What's OJ going to do? Oh. OJ's starting to fight back, the Rage Champion. He's starting to get some momentum going. What's he going to do here? Oh, he's trying to go for a drop kick, but no. Komodo Dragon just burst it. Now, yeah, definitely appears that Komodo Dragon. Oh, splash in the corner. And OJ. OJ right now is just, he's in a world of hurt. Komodo Dragon is just not letting up. He wants to prove that he is indeed, oh, worthy of contending for the Rage Championship. A title that's been NGWF since, 2001. Of course, it got retired in 2012 and then came back not too long ago. Wait a minute! Oh! Right through the Spanish announce table. My God! The Dragon, I think, has got plans with that table. Not entirely sure what's going on here. Sets it up. He's waiting for OJ to get back in. OJ looks like he grabs a crutch. Oh! The Dragon's gonna place OJ right on that table. Wait a minute, he's going up top. Here we go! He's gonna do the Komodo drop! He's gonna do it! OJ, move! Oh, he moves just in the nick of time! Just a split second, but it was just barely enough. OJ's got a chair. Now Komodo Dragon's got a chair. Oh! Damn. Across the head. What is Komodo Dragon gonna do? He grabs yet another table. Let's try not to repeat the mistake he did before. Anyway, what is... Oh, no! Oh, man! Oh! OJ with a sledgehammer right to the ribcage of Komodo Dragon. Wait a minute! Komodo Dragon's got a sleeper hold on! OJ manages to get out of it. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. This is a move I was talking about earlier, ladies and gentlemen. Komodo Dragon's top rope powerbomb. I think he's going to try to aim for that table. Oh, he just barely missed it. One, two, three. Well, regardless, Komodo Dragon wins this match. Like I said, I mean, OJ put up a fight. I mean, he did the best he could under the circumstances, but I think it may have underestimated or overestimated. It's one of those two. Komodo, oh man, Komodo Dragon's strength and brutality. This was a man who was once known as the Leviathan of Destruction and also a former NGWF World Champion. So, anybody you do not want to underestimate, it's Komodo Dragon. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our fourth match of this evening. And this match will be Dawn of Destruction versus the Wolfpack Legion. That's what the wolf is calling his small little group, which consists of himself, Dopes, and Mercedes. Wolfpack Legion attacked Dawn of Destruction. They also attacked Earthquake and also quite a number of other wrestlers in the back. So Dawn of Destruction just isn't fighting for themselves. The in this match. They're fighting for NGWF as a whole. I mean, you guys heard what the Wolf said at the very beginning of this program. You heard what he plans to do. He is not up to... He's not up to anything that is remotely good. Wolf has got himself some very powerful and strong allies. And Dawn of Destruction, they're looking for retribution. They're looking to stop the Legion. No, I mean, the wolf is very, very smart, very clever. He is a cunning strategist. He's not a multi-time champion for nothing. I don't think Dawn of Destruction has ever faced anyone with anything quite like this before. Here they come. Wolfpack Legion. As you can hear from that music, these guys, they're not messing around. They're here to dominate NGW. They're here to take over. Of course, he's looking to become a world champion once again. Of course, he said that Dokes and Mercedes. He's gonna make Dokes and Mercedes superstars. Wolf. Wolf is one of NGWF's most dangerous foes. He has done some things in the NGWF that are more than questionable. So maybe, just maybe, Dawn of Destruction maybe to stop the Wolfpack Legion here tonight, but all I know is that because there is no number one contender for the tag team titles, if Dokes and Mercedes do beat them here tonight, I really don't have any other choice but to make them number one contenders. I mean, Dawn of Destruction don't have opponents for Pac-a-Mania. And the Wolf has demanded that Dawn of Destruction put the tag team titles on the line. Otherwise, they're going to continue the reign of terror. That's part of the reason why Dawn of Destruction wanted to fight him tonight. They also want to get some retribution. For just intense beating that they got from both Mercedes and Dokes about a month ago. Oh, man. DDT from the Wolf. Of course, the Wolf is the most accomplished wrestler in this entire arena right now. He's a one-time world champion, one-time Rage champion, tag team champion, and four-time West Coast champion. He's also the third longest reigning world champion in NGWF history. It's Dawn of Destruction. Two-time tag team champions. They won the tag team titles the second time. Oh, about 2 months ago. Oh man. I don't know anything about this Mercedes guy. All I know is that right now, these two, that both Dokes and Mercedes, have proven to be very strong. And here we go, the monster. It looks like, that monster bomb, but Mercedes gets right out of the way. As I say that, I don't know a thing about Mercedes. He definitely looks very physically fit. We'll give him that. His wrestling style appears to be very technical in nature. Of course, I know all about Dokes. Dokes had a rivalry with the Rapture. back when he was the Bum. In fact, he was one of the quote-unquote monsters that the Bum took out not too long ago. Oh, right now, Dokes is now in the ring. It's going to happen here. Monster going right back into the ring. Wait a minute. Oh, no. Dokes, he's got the monster. Oh! Oh, man. Monster managed to kick out of that maneuver. That was just a hard slam. Peter punches right to the face of the monster. The Wolfpack Legion right now is in complete control. Of course, it's a 2-on-1 handicap match. Hopefully, next week when Iroquois comes back, he'll be able to get some retribution against the Wolfpack Legion as well. Wait a minute, and the monster! Oh, power slam! What? Not even a one count. So far, it looks like Dawn of Destruction is doing everything in their power to make sure that they slow down the Wolfpack Legion, but the Wolfpack Legion is just not slowing down in the least. Right now, they have been almost in complete control. Wait a minute! Power slam! Just incredible strength from the Ghost! No. And now Dokes is in control. He's trying to get him over to the corner of the Wolfpack Legion. Wait a minute. Once again, using his strength, just lifting him up. Oh, stalling suplex. I'm surprised how strong the Ghost is. This is incredible. Wait a minute. Dokes bounces him off. Oh! Power slam of his own. Oh, just repeated punches right to the face, and now the Ghost has been busted wide open. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh! Big backbreaker from the big man, Dokes. Look at the size of him. Wolf, of course, over there with Mercedes, keeping an eye on both Dokes and Mercedes, along with Dawn of Destruction, of course. Wait a minute, here we go. Tags in the Wolf to throw him against the ropes. Clothesline spear maneuver. This is, oh man. The monster's trying to come in. Oh, but no. The Wolfpack Legion gained a victory here tonight. Ah, damn it. I hate it when Wolf is right. The Wolfpack Legion, in their very first match here in NGWF Drop Zone, defeated the tag team champions Dawn of Destruction, which means Dokes and Mercedes will go on to face Dawn of Destruction at a Puckamania for the tag team titles. Oh, wait a minute. Now, come on. There was no need for this. What the hell? Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event match, and it will be between the number one contender for the NGWF World Championship, Mystic Ninja. He'll be facing NGWF World Champion The Rapture here tonight, in what is no doubt going to be a very interesting main event matchup. Now, there has been some rumors lately that Mystic Ninja's contract is going to be up and he may retire from the NGWF. Now, I can't comment on his retirement, but I can confirm that Mystic Ninja's contract is coming to an end. his contract will end at Apocamania, and Mystic Ninja has assured me, he's assured the fans, and he's assured everyone that he is going to beat the Rapture. He's going to put an end to his reign of terror. He's going to put down this beast and become NJWF World Champion before his contract is up. He's going to bring NJWF's championship back to the people. Oh, wow. Wait a minute. And Mystic Ninja is not Mystic Ninja is not waiting. He is right on the offense. And another swinging neckbreaker. As I mentioned before, Mystic Ninja, he wants to bring that championship back to the people. He wants to try to do some good in the NJBF because it wasn't too long ago that Mystic Ninja was with the Wolf, and the Wolf was just trying to use Mystic Ninja to get to the NJBF World Championship because that's the kind of person the Wolf is. Mystic Ninja was part of Mystic Wolf, and he fought against his fellow mentor, Hardcore Eats, in a very bloody, very physical, violent matchup at Heaven or Hell 2013. Oh, man. And ever since, Mystic Ninja has been trying to redeem himself, and he believes that, winning the NJWF World Championship is going to redeem, he will redeem himself in his own eyes and in the fans' eyes. He wants to make sure that he walks away. Oh, man, he wants to walk away as the people's champion. And right now, the Rapture is just destroying Mystic Ninja, not even letting him breathe for even a moment. Of course, the Rapture, once known as the Bomb, he won the World Championship back in May, and ever since he's been nigh indestructible. Very few people have been able to defeat him. No one, though, has been able to beat him in high profile matches such as the one that's going to happen at Apocamania. Oh, man. And there we go. Mystic Ninja was using his technical savvy and using his incredible offense against Rapture, but Rapture is just too brutal of an opponent. He's more about the hardcore aspects of NJWF. He's more about just brute strength and dominance. And right now he's just dominating Mystic Ninja. And Mystic Ninja was gonna try to hit him with that Singapore K, but it was just not gonna work. And wait a minute. Mystic Ninja is now going on the offense. We could see Mystic Ninja fighting back now, and he's bringing the fight to the Rapture. Now both Mystic Ninja and the Rapture have agreed on a stipulation. And that stipulation will be a Hell in a Cell. Oh, that match. So those two are gonna face each other in one of the most dangerous matches you can think of. Of course, the Rapture thinks that he's gonna have an advantage. That's the only reason why he said yes to that kind of match, because he believes that he's gonna have the advantage, and that Mystic Ninja. Wait a minute. Here we go. Superplex! But I don't know if Mystic Ninja's defied the odds before. Just when you think Mystic Ninja is down for the count, he comes back swinging harder than ever, just like that neckbreaker. Mystic Ninja, he's trying to get some offense going against the Rapture, because so far the Rapture has just been dominating this match, and Mystic Ninja, he is trying. Roundhouse kick to the head. What else is he gonna try to do? Grips him, and now he's going right off the arm and just twisting it. And Mystic Ninja working on the arm of the Rapture. Kind of a clever strategy, because the Rapture's finishing maneuver, the Armageddon Hammer, requires the Rap should use both of his arms. So just damaging one of them limits his ability to do that maneuver. Rather clever. There he goes, once again, going after the arm. Throws him against the ropes. What's he going to do here? Oh, kicks him to the side. And, oh, just a beautiful European uppercut. Oh, Mystic Ninja taking a fight to him. What's he going to do here? And Mystic Ninja, oh, slams on the back of his head. He's finally getting some offense going. But is it enough? Rapture doesn't even look all that terribly phased. And Mystic Ninja now, he's got a table. Things just got a lot more intense. And Rapture picks him up. Oh, goes right after his knee. And Rapture now setting up that table. It's not in the right position, apparently. Wait a minute. What's he gonna do? Oh no! Oh! The table did not break! Mystic Ninja! Wait a minute! He's got him down! He's got him in a crossface! Will he tap? Will the Rapture tap here tonight? Will Mystic Ninja get a victory over the Rapture going into Pac-a-mania? Is it possible? No! At least not right now. Him off the ropes. Oh, brings him down, and now just fury of punches, and now Mystic Ninja's been busted wide open. Right now, Rapture now in the attack. Wait a minute, picks him up. Argentine backbreaker. Oh man, that, all that offense is for naught as Mystic Ninja right now. He's hurt. He's holding his ribcage and everything. But like I said, he's defied the odds before. I don't know, Rapture right now, he's in complete control of Mystic Ninja. He's just bleeding all over the ring. Whips him off the ropes. Oh, slams him down hard. Oh, knee across the face. Takes the table. Bashes him in the leg with it. Oh, wait a minute. What's he going to do here? Jumps him against the turnbuckle. He's picking him up. Mystic Ninja is just way too out of it at the moment. Oh, I mean, he's putting it right in position. Oh, no. Oh, wait a minute. What the hell? Oh! Rapture wins. He puts Mystic Ninja right through that table. Just like that. The Rapture has defeated Mystic Ninja here tonight. Will we see this at Pac-a-mania? Will the Rapture beat Mystic Ninja in his final match here in MGWF? I honestly don't know. Oh, man. He just put him through that table. Look at that. Mystic Ninja is bleeding all over his face. Oh, who can stop the Rapture? And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this week's episode of Monday Night Drop Zone. Be sure to tune in 2 weeks from now. We will have our very last Drop Zone leading into Pac-a-mania.